Good morning. So back to Snippet Pixie next development. Let's see where we were yesterday. Okay. So at the point where we have Snippet Pixie looking for when a keystroke is used in something that is accessible, and we don't know what that accessible control is. Hopefully it's an editable text so that we can then catch certain keys and go ping and expand a snippet to a paragraph or whatever. But that's where we're at the moment. We've got this problem whereby we're getting these events coming in. In this case, we're looking for focus events and when the text change insert is happening. And then we need to find out what we've got and do something with it. And then conversely, we've got these window events, when a window's deactivated or minimized or closed or whatever. And when any of those happen, we just want to stop expanding. Although I haven't said that, expanding, we may not actually be expanding. We have not got a control for sure. Expanding's a different thing. So there's certain scenarios where the listener for these events, certainly, text changed, inserted, you do not want to catch those when a snippet is in the middle of being actually expanded. So I might just change that. Let's rename that. Lost control listener connected. So yeah, let's just have this as a no. Let's use refactor tool. We'll call this scope control. That'll do. And then we should have that, yeah. Okay. At the moment, we've got no case where we actually set that to true yet, but we'll get there, hopefully, somewhere in here. So let's just save that. Now, I've just done a bunch of updates and rebooted, so I should probably just double check that this still works. In fact, I'll do clean all from the top. That seems to be okay. I wonder, actually, I've got to make a test. Would I break everything now? Because I'm in the middle of... doing stuff. I wonder if it'll actually be broken. That's a little slow. Maybe it hasn't hit some sort of loop. Okay, that's good. Okay, good stuff. Everything's passing there. And then in here we've got our little snippet pixie daemon. Now this is monitoring stuff, and so if I open an accessible text editor, we can see text changed and focus events. So lots of text change going on there. Get the press and release, same again. Okay, so everything's okay. And when I quit that, It stops. Okay. So that's working. Now we need to work out what on earth we've got. So, that header stuff includes a couple of fields. I don't know what they are. And I don't know whether them or the map in the body includes information that tells me this is good, you can use this. So I need to have a look. I need to find a way of looking at it. What's the field? I'll have a look at the body one first. I don't know whether it's got anything or not in it. Okay, I wonder. Okay, so it's basically a dynamic field, effectively. It can have anything in it. So we don't know, and we have to decide what we think is in it. Is it the same for the headers? Header field and is a variant, okay. I wonder. Okay. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Okay, this is obviously different to what I thought. So field path. So this is the thing, right? So two here. Absolutely is the interface, and that's the member. Text changed. So three So 2 and 3, which means that... Oh, okay. Oops. I was thinking that this was its own field, but it's not. It's part of this. Okay. Totally misread that. So yeah. So remember, element 1 is in theory some sort of accessible. Path. I don't know what that means. And then we've got interface member, and then number 7, 3. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is the sender, which is 1.23 in this case. It's no use to me. Field signature, yeah, is 8. I don't know why it's at G. I don't know what that means. That's also a go thing. I don't know what it means though. But yeah, okay, so there's nothing there that I can really use. There's no good info there. So I think I need to have a look at the body and see if there's anything I can use from the map. I don't know what's in the map. So let's have a quick look at that. I've both got. Our focus is slightly different. No, it's not. It's the same, just it's an empty. Stuff. Okay, what I'll do is I'll just go over it. So I'll just do field in the range of event body. I'm assuming I can do that on a map. And then I'll just print that for the moment and see what we've got. Although what I should really use, I should really go into the debugger and do that. but let's just do this first. We'll see what this does, if anything. Okay. That's just giving me the index. That's not what I want. Okay, come out of that. Let's see if this works. Okay, so we're getting the stuff now. We've got the insert, blah, blah, blah. And the focus has something empty and then a map. Is it an empty map though? Think maybe the best way to do this is to try and run it. How do I do that? I want the daemon. Run this. Oh. Oh, I'm going to take that out actually because that'll be annoying. I'm going to break there. So this is going to get quite messy now. Let's just resize that. Okay. Right, so let's have a look. Event. Body. Cannot read. That's a real shame. There's nothing I can do with that. You're going to have to work it out. Okay. It'd be so much easier if there was an event, which meant, yay, this is definitely editable text. But there is not. Let's see, I want... XML. Let's have a quick look. This is what I can use. So these kind of interfaces here. So I can call the editable text to edit stuff. But there's nothing there that says, hey, I'm an editable text and I've just had some text entered. There is the text interface. It's got properties and methods again. But no signals. I wonder. Okay, so what I'm getting at the moment is this. I'm getting events. I'm getting them for an object. I'm getting things like text changed, insert. And these are all signals. And then focus is the other one. I can't do much with it unless there's a way of saying, hey, what are you? So we've got accessible. Well, that's a good point. If I'm going to use the editable text, how do I address it? I don't. I just have to know I'm in the right place already. Could get a bit messy unless I know for sure I'm in a good thing to do this. Git role. I wonder if that. Hold on, interfaces. Try this. Let's assume let's see if we can poke and say, hey, what interfaces do you have? And if it has editable text, we're good to go. I'm going to leave it a bit like this. So this is a bit squished up, but at least I can use the debugger like this. Right, I need another connection now for accessible. So, we're going to have accessible. Accessible. Yeah, I'm terrible at spelling. Okay, and then here. Oh. Yeah, I need to do that as well. Just in case. And then what we'll do is we will copy this. Got control listener to access. That's it, isn't it? Okay. Accessible com. Fail to connect to Alibus. Accessible. Twice out here. Right, so then we set the accessible thing there, so we've got the connection. It's been stayed, connected true. Okay. And then we want to close. Yeah, need to do that as well, just to make sure. Okay. It's a bit long. I wonder if that all wraps in. Okay. Start lost control listener. That's fine, does its thing. Start, got control listener, it's fine, does its thing. And then in here, just while we debug. Right, don't care about that anymore. Either the control that's in the focus or it's set. I think I didn't finish that to do there. Alright, either the control that sent the focus or insert message. That makes no sense whatsoever. Okay. Right, so let's just do. We need in here access. To an object. So here we go. Right, so let's just do something here. So here we're going to say get accessible interface object. So we can ask. The current control is so we're going to have accessible object is going to be the A dot accessible object that's the interface Oh. Yeah, no. Right, yeah. And that. So, got the interface there. And then here, what is the format again? Is it a lead and slash? It is, isn't it? Yeah. Lead and slash, probably all lowercase. We will give it a go. Doesn't work, we'll change it. Okay, so hopefully we've got an object there. Is this going to return an error? No, just the object. Okay, is that complaining because it's just not used? Okay, and then in here we're going to go in theory we get back, if I'm going to call this interface get interfaces. We're getting back an array of interfaces, hopefully. So we'll try that. Interfaces. Ooh, that's going to clash, isn't it? There's two. Control. Interfaces. I bet there's potentially an error here as well, but we'll see in a sec. So we're calling it on the accessible object I want to call. Get. I think, and then zero is a flag. What do we in theory get back? Oh, just a call. Accessible call there, it's not equal to nil. Then we're just going to go, well, I'll just do continue here because we really don't care. Otherwise, Try that. This could go horribly wrong. Let's do that there. Okay. Right, so it's not doing anything. Must be having an error or something. Let's do this. So we will step over that. Accessible call. Oh, right. Yes, okay. I need to do the full interface, apparently. It's a bit weird, that. Why would you need to do that? Why can't I say I've got an object? Give me the goodies. Okay. Alright, let's see what happens now. Okay. So we have an accessible object, which is looking okay. If I step over, what do we have in here? Got an error again. Service unknown. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. Aye, aye, aye. I bet. Well, that shouldn't have a problem. What's going on? Okay, so got an address. I'm going to step over. We have a connection. Error is nil. Okay. I probably should have gone into that. I probably made a mistake there. I probably should have put a thing on there. I probably need to check that. Okay, so this accessible object, it says it's connected. Step in. Okay, desktop. I'm calling the wrong thing. So that's what I should be doing. And I try to get the object. Oh no, it's not. No, okay. I'm getting confused here. I'm doing the wrong thing. So, I need to do this because I don't have, because I've already done this stuff. I just need to do this effectively. Don't need to go get the object. Just need to call the method. So a accessible get the bus object, call the interface I want with a method. And see what we get. I need to take out that. Then hopefully I'm going to pop in down to here. Let's see. Step over. Got an error again. Unknown interface. Confused. We're in the interface for that. Very confused at the moment. Okay, what about? Maybe I was doing it right. What's the pin? It's case sensitive. Accessible. Can but try. I'm just a bit confused as to why it keeps saying it's not. Not there. Got another error. Why? Okay, maybe it's not. Maybe I need to what if I poke another interface instead and see one that I know exists? So editable text has to exist, because otherwise Snippet Pixie wouldn't be working at the moment. So let's try this. This is really daft. I just need to see whether it's working or not. Oh, golly, AT-SPI. Edit. Parable. Text. I might have to title case that, but I'll check it with lowercase first. And then in here, let's take that out. I'm going to put that here instead anyway. We will set text contents Zero is the flag. I have no idea what that does. And then a string. Wibble. Okay. And let's wrap that in a if statement just so I don't stop myself from doing all kinds of weird things here. Let's do if event body and it was event body 0 equals insert and event body 0, 1, 2, 3. Equals what should I do? Do an at. We'll do that. Very much debug, but we'll just see what happens here. So in theory, when I press the at symbol, it's going to replace the entire contents of that text editor with Wibble. But we will see. Okay, if I do that, nada. Okay. Event body it's a variance. I need to be careful there, don't I? That's a different thing. Yeah. Does it not know? careful. It's not allowed then, sorry. Try that. So we have minor. So I didn't need to make that variant value. Weird. Let's do this so I can see what we've got properly and then determine what to do, because this is a bit weird. There's stuff in things around it. Okay. All right, the variant does need help there then. Can I just say, no? And that's what I really wanted to do, get the string. I can't use any of those unless it knows it's a variant. So I just need to do that. Okay. Fine. Let's see what we're getting now. Okay. Miner. That's not what I want. Just going to do the same thing I had before. Okay, I give up. Why? Why wouldn't that just like give me the value? All right, we'll do that then. I want to do there to the address of the value. But first, I've got to make it into a variant, even though it is, which is nuts. It's the problem, it's not quite. Quite all joined up yet. I need to maybe sort things out there. Maybe need to cast the body in some way. Oh, I'm out of time as well. Okay, one quick check of this. We now have the value we need. Go in. Do it. I've got an error because we've now taken focus away. Service unknown. Yeah, something up there. I am not calling this right because it absolutely is known. I can say that for sure because I can do this. Okay, I gotta go. But I need to work out why. To do. Why is unknown? Okay. That is a question for another time because I've got to go. So until next time, thank you very much and take care. Bye.